Let's meet the offensive starters for the visiting engineers of Worcester Polytechnic Institute. At left tackle, it's number 64, Billy Terrell. The left guard, number 79, Dominic DeCenzo. At center is number 68, Brendan Green. Right guard, number 75, Patrick Haggerty. At right tackle, number 70, Mike Sposato. Tight end, number 81, Douglas Kane. The wide receiver, number 2, Isaac Curry. Number 29, Thomas Emmerich. And number 19, Jay Mizzo. At running back is number 4, Hunter Carey. And the quarterback is number 14, Dante Kachagnia. The head coach of WPI is Chris Robertson. And the officials for today's game, the referee is Brian Finn. The umpire, Justin Brannick. The head linesman is Bob Schuster. The line judge is Steve Campbell. The side judge is Tim Britton. The field judge, James Quant. And the back judge is Anthony Costanza. In other Liberty League action this afternoon, all final scores. Brockport defeated Rochester 23-3. It was Portland 66, Upstate 7. Union 21, Springfield 6. Ithaca defeated Alfred by a score of 52-3. And it was Hobart 17, St. John Fisher 0.
I'm going to walk. Yeah. football, hockey, and baseball. Also, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org. And you can pick up our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. As long as we're sending something over the air, we'll provide it for you on that feed. That is WRPI.org. Once again, this is WRPI Troy with Engineer Football from the East Campus Stadium. Kurt Stutt, Yancey Roy on the call for you today. It is the Transit Trophy game, the RPI Engineers against the WPI Engineers. We will try to avoid using the word engineers during today's game, but if we do, we are probably referring to RPI in that circumstance. So we're going to try to keep it to RPI and WPI through the course of the game.
You know, this is fans are quite aware this is an annual rivalry for these two schools. The rivalry dates back to 1894. That's right, they first met in 1894. And altogether, they have played 114 times. Today's 115th. RPI, the Engineers from New York, lead the all-time series 61 wins to 48 for WPI, and there have been five ties.
Lehane is going to kick off for WPI. He boots it. It's a short kick taken at the 16-yard line by the Engineers. Buckley, 20, 25 to the 30, and he's out of bounds. Where are they going to put him out? They'll have him out around the 33. So RPI starting out in pretty good field position to start today's game.
And Engineers, again, as we said in the pregame, looking to get that passing game going. It's been the inconsistency on offense. Engineers wearing their home uniforms. That's black jerseys with white numbers, red pants, black helmets with the RPI logo in red. WPI in their road whites, white bottom, white top, red numbers, gray helmets with the WPI logo along the side.
RPI going left to right, WPI right to left across your radio dial in quarter number one. RPI on the ground on first down. Burnett's going to take it, dances along the sidelines, and Burnett is out at the 43, close to, if not a first down. He might be a little bit short.
That's Dylan Burnett. He's a fifth-year player. He's leading the Engineers, the RPI Engineers, in rushing a total of 177 yards through the first two games. He's been their most consistent offensive player so far.
They got the first down, so it's first and 10, RPI. No score here. They're on their own 43-yard line, the Engineers. Peter Kusky throws. That is complete to Lombardi, but he's going to lose a little bit. He's going to get caught behind the line of scrimmage and lose 3 yards.
That play was read really well by the WPI secondary, sort of a fake in the middle and a throw to Lombardi in the left flat, and they closed quickly and were on top of him right when he caught the ball. Nowhere to run for Lombardi with that one.
RPI now looking at a second and 13 back at their own 40-yard line. There'll be three receivers to the right, one to the left. That is Walker Sutton alone on the left side. Burnett in the backfield. Peter Kusky is the quarterback for RPI. Out of the shotgun on second and 13. He wants to throw. Peter Kusky finds Lombardi too low. Lombardi had to go down for it. He had a man on top of him, so if he had caught it, he would have had a first down, but he couldn't have gotten any extra yards. But the pass was low.
Yeah, nice coverage by Joey LeClerc, a freshman defensive back who didn't allow Lombardi any room there to make that catch.
That brings up third and 13. RPI with a lot of promise on the first series of downs, getting that first down, but now with a third and 13 at their own 40-yard line. It is sunny, almost no clouds in the sky here in Troy, hanging around 70 degrees right now. Peter Kusky's under pressure. He's going to escape that to the 35, to the 40, stays on his feet, goes to the sidelines, 45, 50, and out of bounds near the marker. And they're going to put him right at the marker at the 47 of WPI, and that should be another RPI first down.
Wow, what a scramble by Peter Kusky. He almost got sacked at about the 30, got out of the pocket, and somewhere around the 41, it looked like he was going to go down, and he just made a quick sort of slide step to the left and avoided two tacklers right at the hash mark at the 40, and then sprinted out to the left and got all the way across the 50 for the first down.
No score here in the first quarter, 13:15 to go in the quarter. RPI first and 10 at the WPI 47-yard line. Two receivers right, one left, and it'll be Allison will go in motion now to the left. He's in the slot position to give us to Burnett. He's going to go left to the 45, gets a blocker to the 40, and Allison picks up 7.
Two nice carries to start the game for Burnett.
Did I say Allison ran it?
You did. Allison is the receiver who went in motion.
Yes.
Burnett was the guy who carried the ball.
I just thought about that. I was like, I got that wrong. It was Burnett. It was definitely Burnett on the run. Second down and three for RPI at the 40-yard line. Peter Kusky gives to Burnett. He's got a hole. He's got a first down. Straight up the middle to the 35 and stopped around the 32.
Wow, there was just a huge surge by the offensive line of RPI. Luke Koschel there on the right side, sort of making the way for Burnett. Also in there was Xavier Gutien, also pushing back. They just drove the WPI line backwards about 3 yards and really opened up a gap for Burnett.
Matt Granieri was injured on that play, and that's why we have a stoppage right now. So there's official timeout as he's going to make his way to the sidelines. He has to go off the field. I think he tried to get into the huddle, but no, because the play stopped because of his injury. He has to go off for at least one play. So he's made his way to the sidelines. No score, 12:15 to go, first quarter. It's a bit windy. You might hear that in the external microphone. It's blowing against RPI. It's
coming from south to north.
South to north, yes.
Right to left on your radio dial, yep.
Yes, RPI is going left to right, WPI right to left in this quarter. So RPI is heading in a generally south-southerly direction. First down, engineers, no score in the first pass. I think that may have been tipped by one of the linemen. It was intended for Walker Sutton. He was off target, but one of the linemen got two hands up, and he might have gotten a piece of that.
I think it was Beck Carrier, one of the linebackers who was coming in from that the quarterback's left side. He's right up on Peter Kusky, and he just had to unload the ball.
Also a rarity in today's game, the WPI pep band is here. It's not them playing, that's the RPI pep band, but WPI's pep band did make the trip here to Troy today. Second down and 10, RPI. To give it to Burnett. Burnett finds a nice hole to the 25. Burnett to the 20, to the 15, and he's down around the 13, 12-yard line. They'll put him at the 13, and that'll be another first down for RPI.
Well, that huge gain is credit to Dylan Burnett reading that play. It was going kind of off the left side, right at left tackle, and that was just completely blocked up, and the pursuit was over there, and he just cut back. He was along the left hash mark, and he just cut back the other way towards the right hash mark, and all of a sudden was through a hole and all the way down to the 13-yard line.
Stepney for WPI injured on that play. He's being looked at by the training staff, so we'll have another stoppage. He's going to get helped off right now.
Dylan Burnett, 44 yards rushing so far in this first drive.
RPI with a first and 10 at the 13 of WPI. 11:25 to go in the first quarter. No score in today's game. They fake the handoff to Burnett. Peter Kusky throws, and it's incomplete, looking for Palmer in the end zone.
Oh, and he was open. Palmer lined up on the right side wide, did a fake step to the outside, cut inside, got inside his defender, and was kind of running along more or less the hash marks, and he had a step on his guy, and he was open, but the pass delivered a little too long, leading Palmer just a little too far, because that could have been a touchdown right there.
RPI's offensive line today, it will be Aidan Montero at left tackle, and then across the line it's going to be Rick Demboski, Thomas Olawson, Xavier Gutien, and Luke Koschel. Quarterback, of course, is Matt Peter Kusky. Running back, Dylan Burnett, as RPI is looking at a second down and 10. To give this to Burnett, he's going to run right. Burnett's to the 10, can't stiff arm his man. He gets pushed out of bounds just inside the 10-yard line.
Gavin Cheff, number 16, a defensive back. Credit him for that kind of stringing out the play and not allowing Burnett to get around the corner on the right side and just forcing him to the sideline, really.
Tight end is Shane Allison. The wide receiver is DJ Palmer, Sterling Walker Sutton, and Peter Lombardi. That's the RPI offense today.
Big play here, third down and 7 from the 10. Obviously, the RPI engineers want to punch this in. Can they convert on what's been a really good drive to open the ball game?
Ball on the right hash mark. Three receivers spread out on the left. Peter Kusky throws end zone. Lombardi touchdown. Finds him straight ahead, almost under the goalpost. That's a TD. RPI lead 6-0.
Well, and Lombardi didn't start out straight ahead. He was far out to the left, and he sprinted straight. He's along the left hash marks. He sprinted straight for the goal line, and once he got to the goal line, made a sharp cut to his right, and that's where he was able to lose his defender by about a step and get open, and that pass was delivered right on the money, a touchdown to Lombardi. And boy, what an opening drive, Kurt, here to start the game, especially for a team who everybody that follows the team knows that they've been struggling offensively.
Merrick on to try the extra point. The kick is up, and it is good. 10:28 to go here, first quarter, RPI 7, and WPI nothing.
And that's got to be positive reinforcement there, not only for the RPI offense as a whole, but especially quarterback Matt Peter Kusky, who became the starter this year. And, well, you know, as the coach said, been inconsistent through the first two games. He's had a struggle out there. He came in 20 out of 48 on pass completions through the first two games. So I would think for RPI to just methodically march the ball down there, and it looked like all of their cylinders were running on offense. Burnett certainly leading the way with the rushing, but then timely passes from Peter Kusky. Also that terrific scramble for a first down at midfield.
Merrick tees up the ball to 35-yard line, getting ready to kick it away. WPI about to get the ball for the first time. Looks like Emmerich is one of the return men on the kickoff. Ball's up. Emmerich will field it at his own 10-yard line, to the 15, to the 20. Stutter steps, gets away from a man, 25, and then pushed down and stopped at the 20, just about the 27-yard line. That's where WPI will start out for their first possession.
I believe that was Gil Rivera on the stop. And now we'll see what happens with the Worcester Polytechnic offense. As we mentioned in the opening, kind of an up and down sort of first 2 weeks of the season, 58 points 1 week, zero the next. And they've had trouble with their passing game, just like RPI has through the first two games of the season.
First and 10, WPI at the 27-yard line. Pass that is complete along the sidelines, 30 and out of bounds. Biesmer is the quarterback for WPI. That play is out of bounds around the 33, so a pickup of 6.
And meanwhile, on the other side of the ball, RPI's defense has just been terrific through the first two games, picking up where they left off last year. Really the unit that's more or less carried the team through much of the season, holding a point. Opponents to just 17 points in the first two games.
Second down and 4. They'll go on the ground this time, but Carey is going to get caught behind the line of scrimmage and loses about 2 yards.
And Kurt, as you mentioned, Biesmer is behind center for WPI. Alec Biesmer, a graduate student out of Kingston, New York. He was not listed as the starter. It's been Dante Cagnia. And we had no update that was going to be changing at all. But as they come out for their first series on offense, it's Biesmer at quarterback.
Carry in as the running back. Biesmer is quarterback for WPI. 3rd and 6. That was a loss of 2 on that previous play. RPI's defense has played very well. Biesmer looks to throw under pressure. Pass, and that is complete along the sideline. It'll be a first down. Receiver goes out of bounds almost immediately, but it's a first down out to the 40-yard line.
And Tommy Emmerich, 29 on the catch. But I tell you, that's Biesmer was running for his life from Amici Conquo, who was coming from Biesmer's left and just bearing down on him. And I think I've got to give credit to Biesmer there. A lot of poise to deliver that pass on the money to Emmerich for a first down, because he was about a second and a half away from being sacked.
Probably less.
Loss. Yeah, maybe less than that.
7-0 RPI leads. 8:40 to go first quarter. 1st and 10, WPI at their own 40-yard line. 2 receivers each side. Carey's going to get the handoff. Goes straight ahead. Gets grabbed from behind, and he only gets a yard before he's pushed back.
Now, Hunter Carey is off to a good start as the feature running back in the WPI offense. He's a junior, and through two games, he has 243 yards on the ground.
Okay, so I called Carey, but was that Hertzig?
I believe it was number four, Carey.
All right. Yes, okay, he's still out there. Yes. All right, so it was Carey. Second down and nine at the 41-yard line for WPI. They'll put one man in motion to the left. More receivers on the left than the right. They're on the line. Biesmer drops straight back. Feels some pressure. He's going to roll to his right. He's at the 40-yard line, and he throws, and it's incomplete. That was a legitimate forward pass. He was right at the line. If any part of you is at the line, it counts.
We were looking for the same thing. He scrambled out of trouble to the right, and he looked like he was going to keep it. And right as he got to the line of scrimmage, he delivered the pass. I was watching the official over there on the far sideline to see if the flag would come out. Boy, it was awfully close. But it goes as an incomplete, and now it's third and nine from the Worcester Poly 41-yard line.
Yeah. So the rule is if any part of your body is at the line of scrimmage or behind it, it's good. Any part, and at least some part of him was. Third down and nine for WPI. Three receivers to the left, tight end on the right. They're going to go to the ground, and Perry's going to get stopped short of a first down. Forward progress had him out to the 44. He got backed up, and it'll be a fourth and six for WPI.
And so a nice first defensive series for RPI. They gave up the first down on the first set of downs, but now holding steady and forcing a punt with 7:20 to go here in the first quarter.
I believe that's Di Loretto back to punt. We'll have to wait for him to turn. Lombardi, and we get a whistle. This play doesn't count. They just snapped it, but it's not going to count.
It's a false start on WPI, so they'll back up another five. Certainly not what they wanted, because now they'll be punting from the line of scrimmage at their own 38. Lombardi, number seven, back to receive it for RPI, standing at about the 21.
We had a lot of punting for the first 2 weeks of the season here at the East Campus Stadium, thanks to some low-scoring games. The punt is away. Spiraling, Lombardi runs up, takes it at the 26, tries to escape one man but can't, and he's down, and RPI will have it at the 25-yard line.
Man, oh man, what a nice coverage play. I believe that was Joe Felix, number seven, a sophomore out of Miami of Florida. Just one-on-one and making the tackle of Lombardi right at about the 25-yard line. And really terrific open field one-on-one tackle there by number seven, Joe Felix.
7-0 RPI lead, 6:44 to go here, first quarter. Engineers, Buckley's in at running back. He takes it on first down and gets a lot more than I thought he would. He's almost got 5 yards near the 30.
Yeah, Christian Buckley giving a breather to Dylan Burnett as we open the second offensive series for RPI. Burnett, one of the stars of that first drive. He had 5 carries for 47 yards. That's about 9.5 a carry, and it's a long gain of 19 in that series.
Second and five, RPI at their own 30. Buckley again, this time he goes left, starts it upfield. Buckley has somebody on his back and is able to get it out past the 40 to the 42 before he's taken down, and that's a first down.
Yeah, he dragged the defender a good 6 yards there at least. He looked like he was tackled or encountered right around the 33 or so. Well, actually, maybe 9 yards, carried him all the way out to the 42.
First and 10 RPI at their own 42, 50 to go here, first quarter, 7-0 RPI leads. 2022 Transit Trophy game.
RPI averaging almost 10 yards a carry right now.
On the ground once more, Buckley, big hole to the 50, and just gets tripped up at the 45, where he could have had another 10-15.
Broken tackle at the 50, and it was just an arm tackle saving Buckley from going all the way.
It was Stepney on the tackle to stop him from going farther. First and 10, RPI, WPI 44, 7-0, RPI leads pass, complete to Lombardi in the flat, to the 40, Lombardi caught from behind, gets it almost 9 yards, he's close to the 35-yard line.
As I said, RPI engineers rushing game really clicking right now. 9 carries, Kirk, for 90 yards. That's right on 10 yards a carry just through the first quarter.
It does not get much better than that. Second and one, just outside the 35-yard line for RPI. And the engineers on the ground once more. They're going to switch up running back, so he'll still get a first down as Kelly is going to take it this time for RPI. And Kelly gets down to the 24 for another first down.
And credit the RPI offensive line. They are just surging forward on each snap and opening up holes for the running backs there, whether it's been Burnett,
Buckley, or Kelly.
Buckley or Kelly.
Four ten to go. First quarter, 7-0 RPI. First and 10 RPI at the 24. Again, this is engineers versus engineers here at the East Campus Stadium, so we're going to try to keep this as RPI and WPI. And Buckley is back in at QB, not at QB, running back, and he's only going to get to the 21-yard line. Zach Newberg, Matt Granary, and Cam Smith are the line up front for WPI. The linebackers are Zach Carney, Harrison, Kiriakow, Jimmy Espinal, and Beck Carrier. And then the cornerbacks are Joey LeClerc and Nate Russell, and the safeties are Rashad Stepney and Gavin Chief. Second down and 8 for RPI. Or 7, they're going to call it now, at the 21-yard line. Scoreboard just changed. Peter Kusky wants to throw. Looks. Lombardi. Does he have it? Yes! Caught it around the three. Got past the defender. Works. It was basically right in front of him. I'm not sure how much he caught that. And it makes it into the end zone. And 13-0 RPI.
Well, you know, Lombardi kind of running to that left pylon, had a step on Wirtz, and the problem for Wirtz and WPI is that he was running with Lombardi with his back completely to the quarterback, never turned around, tried to at the last second, but by that time the ball was delivered right to Lombardi. He made the catch and shook off the defender and ended for the touchdown.
Lombardi on the hole. Merrick's kick is blocked. The defense can pick this up and run it back. It's a loose ball at the 25, covered by RPI. And that's all. So no points on the conversion. It stays RPI 13, WPI nothing.
Well, again, what a terrific start for RPI. We spent the pregame opening talking about the concerns through the first two games were mainly centered on offense. Engineers hadn't really gotten on track. Passing game especially hadn't gotten on track. But look at this, two touchdown drives the first two times they have the ball here tonight. They're up 13-0 over Worcester Polytechnic in the Transit Trophy game. Matt Peter Kusky, starting quarterback, off to a really good start. 4 out of 7, 38 yards. Now 2 touchdowns. All of the completions, by the way, to Peter Lombardi, who has 4 catches for 38. And on offense, or rather on the rushing game, engineers averaging about 10 yards a carry. Dylan Burnett leading the way with 47 here in the first quarter, but also Christian Buckley with 33. Engineers, RPI engineers, already over 100 yards rushing here in the first quarter.
Merrick getting ready to kick the ball. Boots it away. Emmerich takes it to 14-yard line, 15, 20, 25, sideline, 30, out around the 31. So WPI on their second possession with 3:06 to go here in the first quarter, trailing 13-0.
WPI takes over now.
first two-score lead RPI's had this season.
Just 2 points away from setting a season high in points, too. And they were just here in the first quarter.
Yes. Pass to Carey in the flat on the left side, and he's going to get tackled maybe after a gain of one. I think he got out to the 32-yard line. A lot of time only to get 1 yard on that play.
Well, the engineer, RPI engineers defense read that well. Jimmy Lieblow, 23, kind of rushing into the backfield, almost tackled Carey for a loss, just slipped by him. But the next guy there made the tackle up at 32.
So second and nine for WPI. Two men in the backfield. And this is going to be a sack, guys. Not time for Beechner to find somebody downfield. This is going to be a sack back to 28. Sickard on the tackle for RPI and sack. WPI from the third and 13. This WPI offense, left tackle, left one. That's right, Billy Terrell, Dominic Centro, Brendan Green, Patrick Hegarty, and tight end was Douglas King, the wide receiver was Isaac Frederick, Thomas Emmerich, Jay Mezzo, also a wide receiver, running back from Harry, and Alex Beechner. Beechner or Beechner? We'll get that in a moment. Looking to throw here on third down. That is complete near the original line of scrimmage to Frederick. Going to be well short of the first down.
It's the first completion to him tonight. He's been their most dangerous receiver in the first two games, first time they're getting it to him. But the RPI defense right there to allow just a short game. Forcing him yet another WPI punt.
Beesmer, the two deep is wrong with the quarterback's name.
Cole McGrath on the tackle.
Kick is away from WPI. Lombardi takes it at the 35. Didn't call for a fair catch. Gets away from one man, and now he's kind of going to trip up on himself, and he falls at the 40-yard line for a 5-yard return. 53 seconds left in this first quarter. RPI 13, WPI nothing. RPI getting the third possession of the game.
Looking at the team stats so far. Here's Peter Lombardi. He's going to be helped off, not putting any weight on his right leg. I can't tell if that's a knee or ankle. He's being helped to the sideline. It looked like the first guy to come at him after he received the punt might have got him around the ankle, and it seemed like he went down almost without being hit there at the 40, and now he's being helped off to the sideline.
So I said he went down on his own. I think he...
Something happened. It looks like his knee.
I think he planted and something happened when he planted and tried to turn around the 40-yard line.
Yeah, it's definitely the right side knee or ankle.
First down, RPI. Burnett takes it, and he's going to pick up six out to the 46-yard line as RPI's back on offense. So Lombardi does punt returns. He's one of the starting receivers for RPI.
He's caught all four completions.
Two touchdowns
so far in the first. He's been doing everything for the RPI engineers.
He also holds for field goal and extra point attempts. RPI on the ground. Pitch to Burnett, right side, 50. Burnett's got a first down and is out at the 46 of WPI.
Now, nice block there on the outside by Gil Goldsmith, one of the wide receivers. He really pushed his blocker down the field and allowed Burnett to move it across the 50.
Engineers, first and 10 at 45 of WPI. As time is winding down in this first quarter, they don't have to snap the ball, and guess what? They won't. It's over. Well, the first quarter is over here in Troy. It's not all over. The game isn't over, but first quarter is over in Troy. 13-0 RPI leads after one quarter.
And it gives us a chance to look at the first quarter stats. It is no surprise it is just dominated by RPI. First downs, RPI leads 10-1. Rushing yards, get this one, Kurt, 119 yards on the ground for RPI, minus two for Worcester Polytechnic. Passing yards, RPI with 38 and WPI with 18. So your total offense totally dominated by RPI, 157-16. Time of possession isn't all that dominated by RPI. It's 9 minutes to 6 minutes, so that's fairly even. It's just the engineers, RPI engineers, I should say. As we mentioned, both teams are nicknamed engineers. RPI, their offense has looked so much better than the first 2 weeks here. Been unstoppable on their two drives, especially the running game, serving tonight so far to set up the passing game. Every time they've had the ball, and that's why they have a 13-0 lead as we get ready to start the second quarter.
Engineers going right to left. RPI going right to left. WPI going left to right. Across your radio dial in this second quarter. Ball's on the 45 for a first and 10 for RPI.
If you say engineers, you've got a 50-50 chance of being right, Kirk. Tonight, anyway.
No, don't you have a 100% chance of being right?
Oh, actually, right.
You have a 100% chance. Burnett takes it on first down. Can it get away?
That's true.
He was held by the foot. Words got him by the foot, and he got stopped at the 44. He just couldn't get his leg free from Words. So, yeah, so you'd say engineers, you're 100% right.
Yes.
Second and 9 RPI at the 44 of WPI. The sun is setting behind us, so the parts of the field now are in shade as RPI again switching up personnel in the backfield. Get a running play off to the right side and now to the 38-yard line.
That's Joshua Ahrens, freshman running back, getting some playing time. He's a 5'8", 190 out of nearby South Glen Falls High School.
He was not on my cheat sheet.
Well, he's gotten a carry, as I believe has Damian Ming, 26, got one carry in there in the first quarter.
26 is Kelly. We're having a disagreement here?
I got 26 is Damian Ming, and that's what he is on the live stats.
Third down and 3 RPI at the 38-yard line. We know Burnett now has the ball. Finds room on the left side. He's free. To the 30, to the 25. Burnett is down. Inside the 40 for the RPI first down.
He got around the corner at the 40 and was just wide open. Nobody down there to stop him until well down the field. Really nice blocking by the engineers. Among those, Dean Ninchi, wide receiver on the left side, who drew his defender all the way down the field and blocked, opening up that left side for Burnett.
First and 10, RPI, they're at the 20-yard line, 13-1 to go. Burnett's going to take the carry. He's going to be out of bounds around the 18. Ran out of room on the left side. 13-0, RPI leads here. Okay, I have Ming and Kelly with opposite numbers.
Dylan Burnett just piling up the yards now. 10 carries for 83. And we're just 2 minutes into the second quarter. He's averaging better than 8 yards of carry. And it's been mostly the ground game that has really made the difference for RPI so far. Just opening up big holes and then passing the ball as the opportunities present themselves.
Three wide out formation. Buckley in the backfield. Allison goes in motion to the right. And Peter Kusky gives to Buckley. He's going to cut upfield, and he's down to the 15-yard line on second and 8. They'll make it 3rd and 3.
Left side of the line there. Point out Rick Dembosky, among others, opening that gap for Buckley.
So 3rd and 5, engineers at the 15-yard line. Trying to make this a 3-score game on their third possession. Coming up on 12 to go in the first half, 13-0 RPI on top. Peter Kusky out of the shotgun. He's going to get to Buckley. Buckley pushes off one man, stays on his feet, doesn't get a first down. He's down to the 12-yard line for a 4th and 2 now for RPI.
Engineers have tried just one field goal in 2 games, not made any. And with 4th and short, definitely going for it here on 4th and short.
Okay, so Walker Sutton just went in.
He's number 1, he's a wide receiver, but he's lined up in the shotgun.
Yes. We also have Hughes in the backfield. Walker Sutton is lined up in the shotgun as what would be the quarterback, and I use air quotes on that. Walker Sutton takes the ball, and where is he? Yes, he's got a first down. Walker Sutton runs off to the right, and he gets to the 9-yard line, and into a first and goal RPI.
Had to gain just inside the 10, and he had just enough room off right tackle. Got to about the 10 and fell forward across, down to the 9, and it's a first and goal for RPI. 11 minutes to go in the half.
And he stays out there at the quarterback position. Walker Sutton goes to the right once again, and he's inside the 5, down to the 2. And that was on first and goal from the 9. So RPI kept the offense out there, maybe to prevent WPI from switching.
Yeah, and they're keeping him in the quarterback, sort of a wildcat formation.
Yeah, so Walker Sutton takes it again, and he's in for the touchdown. He got hit due to one by Worth. He was able to get over him into the end zone, and RPI leads 19-0.
Yeah, and why was he able to get off that right side? Because the right side of the RPI line, Coastal among others, just blew back the WPI defenders. I mean, they were all behind the goal line, and Walker Sutton did get hit at about the 1 or 2, but there was only one guy. Other than that, it was clear sailing to the goal line.
Maricon tried the extra point, snap spot, the kick is up, and the kick is good. So, Peter Kuski on the hold for RPI. He's now out there as the holder, as Lombardi is on the sidelines, and it seems like Lombardi is coming back into today's game. 20-0, RPI leads, 10:46 to go in the first half.
Wow. Engineers, if you followed the first two games, it struggled on offense. A grand total of 21 points in 3 games. Now, tonight, they have 20 points in the first 19 minutes and 14 seconds of play. It's mostly because of their ground game. 22 carries, 164 yards. That is almost 8 yards a carry. And it's just WPI's defensive line just been getting blown off the ball and has had no remedy for the RPI offense. And I will mention, as you just referenced, about Peter Lombardi, who scored the first 2 touchdowns. He's on the sideline now and using a crutch on his right side. It looked like his knee, maybe his ankle, but probably his knee, that he went off with an injury, and now he's with a crutch on the sideline.
Kick is away, and it will bounce, and finally picked up at around the 5-yard line. Emmerich gets hit, rolls off that, but then he stopped at the 20-yard line, and that's when WPI takes over, first and 10.
It was bouncing toward the near sideline. I think Emmerich waited for a second to see if it was going to go out of bounds and let it go, but it would not, so he had to pick it up and take off, get as much as he could. He did get to the 20. And we've been praising the RPI offense, justifiably so, but the defense doing the job tonight as well. 2 possessions for WPI. They've been held to -2 yards rushing in 2 possessions and just 18 yards passing.
First and 10, WPI at their own 20. Back to the ground. Carey can't get past the first man. He's only going to get 1 yard. That RPI defense, Mache Conquo up front along with Nate Sicard and Josh Cohen. You got C.J. Schumacher, Success Frederick, Joe Deptula, and Connor Noyes in the middle. Cornerbacks to C.J. Lyons and Carlos Davis, and the safeties are Spencer Brockdorf and Jimmy Leblow.
C.J. Lyons, the cornerback on that last tackle.
Second and 9 for WPI, a team that has really got to do something on this drive. Biesmer hands off on second down. Carey tries to go to the left side, and there's just a crowd of black jerseys over there, and he stopped a little bit short of the 23 to set up a 3rd and long.
Well, you got to give credit for a nice effort there by Carey. He did get met at the line of scrimmage, and he put a little spin move on to get out of the tackle and at least move the pile forward a bit for a pickup of 2, leaving WPI with a 3rd down and 7 on their own 23.
Engineers, most everybody's near the line. Not a lot of people back right now. Beesmer looking to throw. He's going to have no time as I'm not sure who's getting the sack on this one. There were so many engineers surrounding him, about five guys around him, and he's going to be considered down at the 16-yard line. That's where they'll blow the whistle, and WPI sends out the punt team again.
Josh Cohen was one of those who bear-tackled the quarterback. I don't know who they'll split that sack among him and somebody between him and somebody else, but like you said, there was a swarm of black jerseys and nowhere for Beesmer to go. And we're going to have a new punt returner for RPI, what with Lombardi's injury.
That might be Walker Sutton out there. DiLoretto boots the ball, high kick, take in. That is Walker Sutton, takes that zone 36, to the 40, to the 45, and Walker Sutton is down at the 46. So it gets about 10 yards on that punt return. RPI starts out close to midfield. 8:29 to go here, first half. RPI 20, WPI nothing.
And take a look at the drive chart so far, Kurt, for RPI. First drive, 11 plays, 67 yards, touchdown. Second drive, 7 plays, 75 yards, touchdown. Third drive, 11 plays, 60 yards, touchdown. It's easily by far best offensive performance of the year early in the season here for RPI.
Peter Kusky, plenty of time. Can he find Palmer? Oh, no. Palmer drops it around the 15.
They went for the home run. Palmer started out on the left and kind of ran a post route across the middle of the field, and he had a step on his defender, and it looked like he got his hands on the ball, like you said, about the 15, but it throw was, oh gosh, just a half a step ahead of him, and he couldn't quite control the ball.
RPI going for the TD on first down, goes incomplete. Second and 10, RPI at their own 46. So I was talking before, the shade has now moved into the middle of the field in midfield. Peter Kusky throws to Allison, complete to 45, 50. Allison breaks one tackle, 45, and now pulled out of bounds on WPI side of the field, but not after he gets the first down. That was Chief who took him out of bounds at the 40.
Allison was lined up tight on the left side, and he just kind of flared out into the flat and made the catch, and that was all like yards after the catch because he caught the ball really in the backfield. That's the first completion to a receiver other than Peter Lombardi.
Clock is running, 7:50 to go, first half, 20-0. RPI leads WPI in the Transit Trophy game. First and 10, RPI at their own 40. Two receivers, Nelson on the right, one on the left. Handoff goes to Burnett, and he's going to get caught by, it looks like Wirtz got him. Yeah, Wirtz, I've said his name a lot already. That'll be a gain of one for RPI.
And for once, an RPI rushing play doesn't get very good or decent yardage. Probably the first time tonight.
Second and 9 at the 39 of WPI. Most of the receivers will be on the right this time. Peter Kusky to Burnett in the flat. Picks up the ball. They're going to call it a forward pass. Wisely he picked it up, but it was a forward pass.
A case of trying to run with the ball before you catch it there. They're trying to set up that wide screen to Burnett. The ball was right on target. I think he just kind of looked ahead for a split second and couldn't make the catch. I wonder if the sun might have also, not to excuse it, but he was standing in the sun. The quarterback was in the shade. Maybe that was a factor as well.
I think he ran out from the shade to the sun for that play.
Right, right. Yeah. I said Burnett was in the sun. I'm sorry, and quarterback was in the shade. Maybe that was part of the reason for the drop there as well.
Third down and 9 at the 39-yard line for RPI. Peter Kusky to throw. Running out of time, under pressure, runs away from it along the 45-yard line, and he's near the 40. Now he puts it up, and that'll be incomplete. Palmer got it, but he got it out of bounds, so it's incomplete.
That was one of those get rid of the ball before you get sacked throws. He was being chased towards the sideline, and Peter Kusky, you know, at least threw it in a place where no defender could get to it, and he didn't take the sack as well. So
they're sending Burke out Also number seven, if you're watching, Burke and Lombardi share the number seven. That is Burke out there for punting duties.
Freshman who has seen a lot of time already kicking for RPI.
Hughes, a receiver, is one of the upmen. And
we got a whistle.
I think this is the delay of game. I think the play clock ran out.
I suppose arguably the first mistake the engineers have made on offense all night.
Was it? Maybe they were just trying to see if they could get WPI to move. Ball's now on the 44 for what is 4th and 14. Now they'll snap it back to Burke for the kick. He boots it. That's going to go long and into the end zone. It'll be a touchback out to the 20. So 6:44 to go first half. RPI 20, WPI nothing. And WPI gets at their own 20-yard line.
He was aiming for the coffin corner on the left side and got it down there. The ball hit it about 3 or 4. But instead of bouncing to the left of the sideline, it went straight into the end zone.
Yeah, I'm not sure that wasn't somewhat intentional, taking the delay of game.
To give him a little more room to try that, yeah.
Room to try it, or see if they'd move.
Yeah.
Yeah, just don't try to draw them, but see if they end up throwing you 5 yards, and then maybe you put the offense back out there.
RPI defense back on the field. So far, they've held WPI to minus 6 yards rushing.
Biesmer throws, and that's almost taken away by the engineers. It was intended for Kane, but Brockdorf got a hand on it.
Yeah, that was one of those where the quarterback telegraphed that where he was going with that for a ways before delivering the ball, and Brockdorf was deep as the safety, but he could see that the quarterback was throwing to the far sideline and got over there with enough speed to get a hand on the ball and knock it away.
And that is the WPI pep band you can hear right now. Second and 10 at the 20-yard line for WPI. Biesmer gets rid of it right before he was about to get hit. Carey gets the reception, and he stopped around the 22. Well, Biesmer had a little bit more time, but clearly he was outnumbered heavily in the backfield.
Well, they were trying to set up a screen play on the right side there to Carey, but RPI defense wasn't really fooled. C.J. Lyons, number 2, in on the tackle, I believe also with Connor Noyes, number 54. One first down so far for WPI, and I believe that was on their very first set of downs tonight.
Third down and 8. Biesmer drops back. Now he's going to run with the ball to the 25. Biesmer dashing around. He's got room on this left side. He's going to make it out towards the sidelines, and he's got a first down close to the 40. And so WPI keeps the drive going.
Boy, a nice run by Biesmer. He used the stiff arm to get away from one tackler right at about the, well, actually it wasn't a stiff arm. It was just sort of a sidestep and a stiff arm to get away from C.J. Lyons right at about the 28, 29-yard line, which if he'd have gone down there, he would have been short of the first down. But he sidestepped Lyons, got out on the outside all the way to the 40.
First and 10, WPI at their own 40. RPI leads 20-0 with 5:20 to go in the first half.
That was the longest running play of the night.
Carey gets the handoff and is immediately met by Deptula and is caught for a loss. Literally, he got the ball and then he got hit.
Yep. The play before that, that quarterback draw, Aaron Biesmer on the keeper, went for 18 yards, by far the longest carry on the night for WPI. Team-wise, total, they have 9 rushing attempts for a total of 10 rushing yards.
Loss of 2 makes it 2nd and 12 for WPI. They're on the left hash mark as the shade is moving. They're in the shade now, most of them. The left part of the line is still in sunlight.
And lights are on here, too.
2nd and 12. Biesmer keeps it himself. He gets to the 40, still pushing, and he's out to the 42. That picks up 4 yards and makes it 3rd and 8.
Biesmer's passing numbers aren't bad in terms of completions, 5 out of 7. But just for 20 yards and They haven't even had time to set up to go anything deep at all. I mean, Isaac Frederick, their senior wide receiver, came into this game with averaging 25 yards a reception, but they've thrown just one short pass to him so far tonight.
Third and eight at the 42. Thiesmer throws over the middle, and is it caught?
I believe it is. Short
Kane,
of the first down.
Kane caught it at the 48, but he's short of a first down.
That's a tight end. Beesmer was under heavy pass rush pressure there and just had to unload the ball quickly. Maybe that was why it was kind of low to the ground, and Kane, Douglas Kane, 81, a tight end, had to kind of go down to the ground and make that catch. Fourth down, and it looks like they're going to go for it at midfield. Hey, you're down by 20 points already. WPI looking to make something happen here.
Or they could be looking to draw RPI offside.
Well, yes.
So let's see. There's 8 seconds on the play clock. They're all bunched up near the line. Beesmer is under center. They are going to snap the ball. He'll turn around, hand it off to Carey, and Carey's not going to make it. There's just a pile of about 18 players near the 50 on the R of RPI, yeah. And they're not near the 50, and so WPI turns it over on downs at their own 49-yard line.
I was a little surprised by that play call there, Kurt. I mean, WPI knows its strengths, obviously, but they have not gotten anything really on the ground tonight. 10 rushing attempts, 14 total yards. The only good rushing play they've run was the quarterback draw. I think I was kind of expecting for some sort of fake to the running back carry and a pass to try to get those 2 yards for the first down.
First and 10, RPI at the WPI 49. 3 to go here in the first half. 20-0, RPI leads. Buckley gets the handoff. He's going right, and he's going to get pulled down around the 48. Forward progress may have gotten him to 47. I don't know. Official on the near side wants him at the 47, but on the far side, they're looking at the 48. It'll be the 48. So clock is still running. Both teams have 3 timeouts. 2:40 to go in the first half. WPI will get the ball to start out the second half. 2 receivers left, 1 right for RPI. Buckley in the backfield. Peter Kuski out of the shotgun.
Buckley a nice night so far as well, just like Burnett. Buckley 7 carries, 40 yards here in the first half.
Peter Kuski rolls left after getting the snap. Throw complete to Walker Sutton, and he'll step out as he tried to turn up field. He's out around the 44. RPI now looking at a 3rd and 5.
Peter Kuski now 6 out of 12, 56 yards so far in the first half, and 2 touchdowns.
RPI letting the clock wind down. 3rd and 5 at the 44. Peter Kuski has 4 receivers going out to each side. Peter Kuski under pressure, and he'll get sacked back at the 49. That was Kiriakau on the sack for WPI.
And what would normally be a... Well, I was going to say, they hesitated a bit before sending the kicking team out. I was wondering if, because it was just a minute and 20 left, whether they might go for that. But they're not going to take any chance. 4th down and 12 to go. Just go ahead and punt it away.
If it had been 3 or less, I think they would have gone for it. But
I would have been surprised because we were looking at like 4th and 12 here.
Yeah, that seems too long at this point. Back to Burke for the kick. He's going to send a high kick towards the sidelines, and it bounces out of bounds near the 10. So WPI with 59 seconds left will have it at their own 11.
And each team with 3 timeouts left. I don't know if that will come into play here with 59 seconds to go in the half.
I think it will.
It depends how aggressive RPI wants to be here. They've certainly bottled up WPI all night. If you want to be aggressive, you call a timeout after every play and maybe get it back with a little bit of time left.
Make them run plays.
Make them run plays. We might know right here on this first play.
Well, if they don't call a timeout on the first play, then
they're going to let the clock go. They're up 20-0 here in the first half. It's been a best half of football by far for the RPI offense all year.
First and 10, WPI at the 11. Biesmer has to run with it. He's to the 14, 15. He's out of bounds. So he's out at the 15. Clock stops with 53 seconds to go in the half.
Amici Conquo, again, the first guy in the pocket and just flushing Biesmer out and forcing him to run to the right.
Second and six, they'll call it at the 15-yard line. Biesmer wants to throw again, rolls out to his right, looking downfield, throws, tipped, and caught! Caught by Emmerich at the 31. That gets WPI a first down.
Well, better lucky than good, as the saying sometimes. Biesmer threw that into a pile of people right at about the 25. It was tipped by at least one guy and lands right into the hands of Emmerich for the first down.
Biesmer, his throw is deflected and goes incomplete. We have 34 seconds left. It'll be a second and 10 for WPI at their own 30 with RPI up 20 to nothing.
I believe it might have been Shoemaker or maybe Sicard who got it. I thought it was Sicard who got his hand on that.
That stops the clock. So nobody's taken a timeout yet. There's still 34 seconds left in the half, and nobody's used a timeout. Second and 10 at the 30 for WPI. Biesmer, short drop, throws, intercepted by the Engineers. RPI to the 25, to the 20, to the 15, to the 10, and a touchdown, RPI. Connor Noyes returns it to the end zone. RPI leads 26-0, and a flag comes in late. We'll have to see what this is, but Noyes with the INT, no, this might not count. The back judge is putting it at the 15-yard line.
That ball just kind of fluttered like a wounded duck up in the air, and I was watching the replay screen to see if anybody tipped it, and nobody did. It was just Biesmer had his arm cocked back with the ball, and as he followed through, he just lost the handle. And it's not going to be a touchdown. It's going to be a penalty for a blindside block on the interception return. So take the touchdown off the board, and they're going to bring the ball all the way back out to the 30, where RPI will have it with 25 seconds to go. But tough break because for Connor Noyes, because defensive guys don't get to score that often. And he had what looked like a touchdown, running it all the way down the left sideline. But the penalty will bring it back to the WPI 30. With 25 seconds to go.
Yeah, I was going to say, RPI still has three timeouts. They're on the 30 of WPI with a 20-point lead as time is running down in this first half. Peter Kusky rolls right on first down, looking downfield, throws, and I don't think that was caught in bounds. No, that was out of bounds when it was taken by Goldsmith.
Yeah, Gil Goldsmith sprinting to the right side, had to go up high for it, got his hands on it, but couldn't get the feet down. In bounds as he was coming down with the ball.
It does save a timeout for RPI. At this point, time is more of a factor than timeouts. There's 20 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, because they have three timeouts, they don't have to throw to the sideline here to get anyone out of bounds. They could run a play right down the middle if that's what's open. So the entire field is open for Peter Kusky to work with here.
Second and 10, two receivers right, two to the left. Peter Kusky dropped, five-man rush. He moves up, gets away from one man under pressure. He's still on his feet, and now he's going to get stopped and timeout with 10 seconds, 9 seconds on the clock. That's what it's going to be. So in this circumstance, if you're Peter Kusky, you are probably better off going to the ground a few seconds sooner.
Or just flinging it away. Mohammed Berry, number 89, among the WPI defenders, kind of encircling Peter Kusky and finally wrapping him up at the 32.
So RPI takes a timeout.
They do put 2 seconds back, so it's 11 now.
Yeah, it's 11 seconds left. But if right now, as I said, time is a bigger issue than timeouts. So if you're running into trouble and it looks like you can't get out of it, your best bet is usually to fall to the ground and let the team take the timeout. Good time to remind you, you are listening to WRPI Troy with Engineer Football from the East Campus Stadium on the Troy campus. RPI 20, WPI nothing in the Transit Trophy game for 2022 with 11 seconds left to go in this first half.
If you missed any of the start, the first three possessions all resulted in touchdowns for RPI. It's the best they've looked on offense all year, and that's how they're up 20-0 here.
Third and 13 with 11 seconds to go. Two receivers each side. Burnett's the running back. Peter Kusky out of the shotgun. Scanning the field under pressure, and he's going to get thrown down by Newberg at the 45-yard line. And RPI will take a timeout with 6 seconds to go. It's fourth down now, so it's one play.
A terrific play by Zach Newberg, one of the defensive linemen for WPI. Just moving in quickly on Peter Kusky, who tried to sidestep him but just really couldn't get away. Newberg wrapping him up quickly all the way back at the 44.
So there are 6 seconds left. If you're lucky, you might get a second play. Let's call RPI. At this point, it would be a 61-yard field goal. They are out of field goal range. 44. Yeah. Okay, let's say that. So you're looking end zone. It is unlikely, even with the timeout, you'll get a second play.
Right. It would be, you know, to do that, what do you get? Like,
You have to think,
five and out just to pick up 5 or 6 yards for one last second play.
It's at least 2 seconds for your quarterback to drop back.
But it's fourth down, so you have to throw the ball down the field. You can't do one of those five and outs.
Right. So it's got to be downfield. It's at least you snap the ball 1-2 before the quarterback is probably going to let it go and time in the air. So you've maybe got one play here. Fourth down and long. Peter Kusky drops back. Four-man rush. Puts it in the air. Time will expire. In the end zone. It's up. It's down. It's incomplete. And that's the end of the first half.
A couple of guys got their hands on the ball. Sterling Walker Sutton among them in that group, but I believe, or maybe it was Goldsmith. But, just a pile of receivers, or rather a pile of players about 5 yards deep, and no one coming down with it. But that's the end of your first half. And as we've said, best half of football all year for RPI, especially on offense. Leading WPI 20-0. If you miss the first quarter, you miss a lot. The Engineers, first three times they had the ball, three touchdowns, drives of 67, 75, and 60 yards. And their first three possessions building the 20-0 lead. Meanwhile, the defense has been all over WPI, holding them to 19 yards rushing and 41 yards passing in the first half.
That pretty much says it all for that first half. WPI will get the ball to start out the second half. It's locker room time for both teams to talk about this one. And if you're WPI, what's going so far hasn't been working. They need to find some other methodology to get the ball downfield.
Yeah, and the Engineers' offensive
live coverage of Engineer Football on 91.5 FM, WRPI, Troy.
Honda, 770 Hoosick Road, Troy, or visit online at getahonda.net. Come experience why Rensselaer Honda is simply better. And now let's welcome the RPI cheerleader team to the field.
Yeah. Thank you.
RPI, and RPI has a 20-0 lead after one half of play. My name is Kurt Sutt here with the NC Roy. We're bringing you all the action live on 91.5 FM WRPI Troy. Before we get started with the second half, we would like to thank the Rensselaer Union. They provide the funding for WRPI and all the club-related activity of the Institute, and that includes WRPI's coverage of engineered football, hockey, and baseball. And also, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org. And you can pick up our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, as long as we're sending something out over the ether of the air. We'll provide it for you on that feed. That is WRPI.org.
Well, we can take a look at some of the numbers behind the reason the RPI engineers built a 20-0 lead here in the first half. Their first three drives, if you missed them, 67 yards, 75 yards, 60 yards, all resulting in touchdowns. Best offensive performance of the year for RPI, building up that 20-0 lead. They were especially devastating on the ground. Dylan Burnett leading the way with rushing with 84 yards. Christian Buckley also with 40. Quarterback Mac Peter Kusky, just 6 of 14, 56 yards, but two touchdowns, both caught by Peter Lombardi.
Merrick boots the ball as we are underway in half number two, and Emmerich has to field that one at the five-yard line. Didn't take a bounce towards the sidelines. 15, 20, Emmerich 25, running across the field, across the 30, and pulled down around the 33, and that's where WPI will start out this second half. It's WPI going left to right, RPI left to right across your radio dial in this third quarter. Lights are on here at East Campus Stadium. The clouds have actually moved in, but the sun is going down behind the building, so there's no more of that sun, not sun, or sun shade situation on the field anymore.
And besides the RPI offense, the RPI defense was also part of the story of the first half. They were just really held Worcester Poly in check through the first two quarters, holding them to just three first downs, just 19 yards rushing, and just 41 yards passing.
First down, Kachagny is in there for WPI, and he's going to pass. That's complete along the far sidelines. Kachagnia on the pass. It is completed out to the 37, and that's a pickup of about five for WPI.
Yeah, Dante Kachagnia, number 14. He was listed as the starter, but then he didn't come out in the first half. In fact, it was Alec Biesmer. And now as we open the second half, Kachagnia is back in.
Second and five on that five-yard completion for WPI. Kachagnia is out of the shotgun. Fakes the handoff to Carey. He's going to throw. That is incomplete at the 42, right near the marker. Emmerich went down to a knee to try to get that, but it bounced in front of him, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, delivered a little low. The receiver had to go almost down to a knee to catch it, and then he had some room. I think there was a combination of it was a low throw, and also he tried to get up and run with it before completing the reception.
WPI quickly looking at a third down as we're early in this third quarter, 20-0, RPI on top. Two receivers to the right, man in the slot, and a tight end on the left. And Chagney gets away from one guy. They'll pass. That's complete to Carey on the far sideline. He's near a first down, and a late flag comes out. There was one engineer. That was Conquo, who was in a tussle with somebody. I don't know who's going to get called for
the
this.
Pocket.
That's going to be Conquo called for the unnecessary roughness. So the ball was actually 1 yard short of a first down as Carey got the completion. But the 15 yards gives them the yardage and, of course, the automatic first down with it. So WPI will move into RPI territory.
And you know, Conquo was closing in on the quarterback, coming from behind for the sack. And it looks like he made contact after the throw, but I think it was, you're right, I think it was maybe the scuffle after that, because they didn't call roughing the passer. They called unnecessary roughness, which indicates it was the little scrap afterwards with one of the WPI players.
13:53 to go, third quarter, 20-0, RPI leads. WPI first and 10 at the RPI 44-yard line. Kachagnia throws. That's complete along the far sideline, right at the line of scrimmage, and Herzig is down after a gain of one. He got swung forward by the defender, and he's down at the 43.
Yeah, Connor Noyes, the defender on the play there, read it the whole way, just wrapping up the receiver after a very short gain, maybe a yard. I guess I'll give him 1 yard to the 43.
WPI coming into today's game 1-1, coming off a loss last week. Both teams coming off losses last week. Chris Robertson is the head coach for WPI. Of course, Ralph Iserni, the head coach for RPI. Oh, I wish we could use nicknames today. Carey gets the handoff. Carey gets the handoff on second down, and he stopped at the line of scrimmage.
And that's Stephen McDonald, who came in as quarterback there for one play. It looks like, and he's staying in now, so sort of a rotation here. We saw Biesmer at quarterback the entire first half instead of Kachagnia. Kachagnia opens the third quarter, but after a few plays, he's out, and now McDonald is in at quarterback. Stephen McDonald, a junior, 6'1", out of Georgetown, Mass.
So third down and 10 as WPI was stopped at the 44-yard line. McDonald takes the snap, throws. That's complete to Carey at the line of scrimmage. He'll get caught inside the 44, down to the 38 goes the ball, but that's 4 yards short of a first down.
And that's Connor Noyes again, that was set up for a screen, and Noyes was in the backfield rushing the quarterback, turned around and scurried to the ball and caught Carey from behind at the 38, setting up now what's a fourth and four, and Worcester Poly down by 20 points. They're going to go for it here.
Or
try to drive him offsides.
Yeah, could be. Kachagnia is back in as quarterback for WPI. Carey is behind him as the running back. Two receivers to the right. One man in the slot to the left. Fourth and four, they're going for it. Kachagnia puts the ball in the air, and that is broken up by the defense. Brockdorf got over there to get a hand on it. Was not well thrown for the receiver. And WPI turns the ball over on downs at the RPI 38.
Yeah, Kachagnia didn't have a lot of time. That's why he didn't deliver the ball particularly well. He had to unload it. Brockdorf, playing that deep free safety, saw the play developing, came over there and sort of just reached over, jumped before the receiver ever even made a leap for it, and just batted it away. And RPI gets the ball back on downs at its own 38 for its first possession here of the second half.
First and 10 RPI, 11:27 to go, third quarter, RPI 20, WPI nothing. RPI looking to the sidelines. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. You got a man in a slot to the left, pass, that is complete to Goldsmith, 40. 45, Goldsmith keeps moving, and he's just about a half a yard short of a first down as he got caught just beyond the 47 by Wirtz.
Sort of a wide receiver screen out there, and a nice blocking by Allison and Walker Sutton to set up that gain for Goldsmith.
Second and one, they'll put it right on the 47-yard line. Burnett takes the carry, first down as he crosses the 50 and gets to the WPI 49.
Evan Wirtz, linebacker for WPI, a guy's whose name we've called a lot today on the tackle.
Should also mention Brian Finn is the referee for today's game. He has not had a lot of explaining to do today. It's been a well-played game in terms of penalties. First and 10 RPI at the WPI 49. Peter Kusky has time to throw, loses the ball, batted out of his hands. He picks it up while he's on a knee, and that's it. Play's dead.
I think that was Wirtz, perhaps, number four, who might have gotten an arm out there that forced Peter Kusky to lose control. He was certainly one of those guys applying pressure for WPI.
Loss of six on the play, second and 16.
Frankie Polito, 58, was also in on pressure for Worcester.
Ball's at the 45 on RPI side of the field right now. They've gone back from across the 50. Peter Kusky gives to Buckley. Buckley
might have lost the ball.
May have lost the ball. I was going to say he got hit oddly and fell backwards at the 49 of WPI, but I couldn't really see if he had the ball or not at that point. And we're waiting for the referee. What are they going to signal? They haven't signaled anything right now. WPI's arguing they've got the ball, and they have the ball.
They do.
They do. That's a fumble, and it looks like Buckley is still down. Now that everybody's moved away, we can see that Buckley is still on the ground.
There was quite a collision between him and one of the WPI linebackers. I don't know if it was Polito. I didn't quite pick up the number there. Right at midfield, really hard collision with Polito coming in from the side, I believe. And now Buckley heading to the sideline with some assistance and limping noticeably. The engineers have already lost one of their offensive stars tonight, Peter Lombardi, a wide receiver who does a little bit of everything, punt return, scored two touchdowns tonight. He went down with a knee injury, is now out of uniform and on crutches on the sideline, and now we have Buckley going off with some assistance and hobbling towards the bench.
9:36 to go third quarter, RPI 20, WPI nothing. RPI has just fumbled, recovered by WPI at their own 49. As WPI trying to do something. Cachagna throws it downfield, and that's knocked away. That pass was intended for Mezzo, but it got knocked away by the D. Brockdorf was back there.
Along with C.J. Lyons. Yeah. The receiver had a step on C.J. Lyons, but Cachagna's pass was actually a little underthrown down at about the 10. If he gets a little bit more under the ball, and you can get it just maybe 3 or 4 yards deeper, that could have gone for a WPI touchdown, because Lyons was the defender was a step behind on coverage there.
Incomplete on first down, second and 10 at their own 49 for WPI. Cachagna fakes the handoff, rolls left, throw. That is complete to Emmerich, but he's tackled at the line of scrimmage, and that'll be a no gain. Schumacher came in for the. Was that Schumacher?
I think it was Carlos Davis. Davis 13. Came in. Boy, what a tackle there. He just came flying in and hit the guy at the hip and just took his legs right out from under him. And the ball's down at the 48. Now back on the WPI side of the field, and it's going to be third and 11.
WPI getting their best start in terms of the drive at their own 49 on their seventh possession. And so far, they're a minus one on this. Third and 11 at the 48, two receivers each side. Cachagna drops back. Now he's going to start to run with the ball. He's going to run with it himself, and he's out of bounds at the 44 of RPI, and that's not enough for a first down.
It would be surprised if they go for it again here. They've already gone for it once on a fourth down situation just like this. Cachagna was under a lot of pressure and probably made the wise decision to just get the heck out of the pocket and run for it and get as much as you can. He did get down to the 44. And fourth down and about three. One player that we haven't called his name a lot tonight is Frederick, one of the receivers for WPI. He came in averaging 25 yards a catch. They've only thrown to him once so far tonight.
Fourth down and three. Kachagnia fakes the handoff, rolls right, looking downfield. Now under pressure, throw. That is complete to Emmerich at the 37, and that's a first down.
Well, nice recognition there by Emmerich. Kind of came back to the ball on the near sideline, just helping out his quarterback to get something. And all they needed was three. They end up getting about seven down to the Engineers' 37. And deepest possession now of the evening into RPI territory for WPI.
20 to nothing, RPI lead, 7.5 to go, third quarter. First and 10 WPI at the 37 of RPI. Kachagnia throws in the flat. That's complete to Carey. Carey back to the line of scrimmage and about a yard more to the 36. So one of the reasons Frederick isn't getting mentioned is because they're not throwing deep.
No, not at all. And it's because RPI's defensive line is just not giving any Worcester quarterback much time, whether it's Kachagnia, McDonald, or whomever. Often there's someone back there with him. Michi Conquo, among those names that we've called on defense a lot for putting pressure on the Worcester quarterbacks.
Second and 9. Carries in the backfield, all the receivers, tight end on the left, three receivers on the right. And Kachagnia throws, that is complete to Frederick, and he's going to get down to the 32, and so that's a gain of about 4. So another third, and it's about 5 for WPI.
Cole McGrath, number 5, in on the tackle for RPI. Again, this is the best opportunity so far this game for Worcester. They've not been this far into RPI territory all night.
Third and 5. Kachagnia out of the shotgun. He's going to throw, and he's going to get hit, and he is sacked back to the 44-yard line. Noyes on the sack for RPI, and now it's a fourth and very long.
There was 3 RPI guys bearing down on him. Noyes was the first one to get there, but he was in a heap of trouble within seconds of receiving the snap. And so now, fourth down, they've gone for it on short, fourth and short, 3 or 4, but now with a fourth down and 13, it looks as though WPI is going to elect to send the punt team out. And instead of going for it, they're going to try to pin RPI deep in its own territory.
DiLoretto to punt. Walker Sutton to return the punt. Lombardi, the usual punt returner, is out of the game with an injury. Good snap. Kicks away. High kick. Walker Sutton signals for a fair catch, and he will take it around his own 14. 4:53 to go in the third quarter. RPI 20, WPI nothing.
Well, another, let's give another credit to the RPI defense there, holding WPI to really not much on that drive at all. They got the ball after a fumble at midfield. Worcester taking over at its own 49. And although they got eventually as far as the 37, they end up netting just 11 yards on that drive. 7 plays and just 11 yards. So, again, credit to the RPI defense.
Handoff on first down for RPI as they were first and 10 at their own 14, and they'll make it out to about the 19-yard line. That is Burnett in at running back for RPI. They call it the 18. 2 receivers to the left. Man in the slot to the left, tight end on the right as RPI quickly went to the line. And now they're going to slow it up.
Yeah, wouldn't be surprised to see a conscious effort to run the play clock down almost every play here in the second half.
RPI getting to the line to prevent WPI from making a change, but then taking the sweet time after that. Burnett takes the carry, crosses the 20 on the left side and makes it out near the 23. About a yard short of the first down, so it'll set up 3rd and 1. Check out of town today. Everybody else is final today. Brockport defeated Rochester 23-3. Portland 66, Buffalo State 7. Union over Springfield 21-6. Ithaca defeated Alfred 52-3. And Hobart coming back from their loss against Morrisville State last week, defeating St. John Fisher 17-0. RPI on a third and one. Will they get it? I don't know where they're going to spot this. He may have it.
That was Walker Sutton in sort of the wildcat formation that we saw at the goal line in the second quarter. I think he's got enough. They're marking him at the 24.5, and I think he had to get to the 24.
It is a first down.
First down.
First down for RPI. 3:15 to go, third quarter. RPI 20, WPI nothing. RPI with the ball. Looking for some good ball control here. WPI, you mentioned, not a lot of yards on their possession. But that was over 4.5 minutes of time to end up with about 11 yards. Peter Kusky throws on first down. And that is complete. Ball comes popping out, and WPI has recovered on the far side. And this could be a touchdown. Nope. They're first of all, it's a completed pass, a fumble recovered by WPI. I think Smith got that.
Cam Smith.
Yeah.
Number 9.
And he's out of bounds around the 27.
Okay, yeah. It was completed, as you mentioned. It was initially completed to Dean Ninchy, number 9. Headed up the field, got hit, and the ball just sputtered up in the air, kind of end over end, in the right time, right place. Right there was Cam Smith, number 9 for WPI, making the pickup at about the just across the 30. He headed down the sideline, and as you said, it looked like he had a chance to go all the way. Dylan Burnett knocked him out of bounds at 10, but the official said he stepped out of bounds much sooner. They're going to mark it back at the 27. Nevertheless, big turnover, big chance for WPI. Best starting position of a drive all night. They're down 20-0. If they're going to make it a game, they can't afford to miss on this opportunity.
2:44 to go, third quarter. RPI with a 20-point lead. WPI with the ball at the RPI 27 after the fumble. And Cachagna, flag comes out. Cachagna throws. That is complete. Nice one-handed grab by Frederic. Frederic gets it down to the 15, but I think this is coming back.
It's in the area where you usually see holding called.
Holding. Offense. Number 68. 10-yard penalty from
the
previous spot.
That's Brian Finn, the referee, indicating the hold is against WPI, and that will back them up 10.
Before that, WPI just had one penalty all night, so really bad time to pick up your second. Pushes it all the way back to the 37, first down and 20 now.
WPI not doing themselves any favors. Cachagna out of the shotgun. Carey was in the backfield. Cachagna under pressure,
oh,
and
boy,
he's going down back at the WPI 47. Sicard.
94, Nate Sicard. Totally blown blocking assignments there by WPI, and Cachagna never had much of a chance. So after the interception, WPI has the ball on the 27. Two snaps later, are all the way 24 yards backwards at their own 49. One on a penalty and one on a big sack.
So it is second down, because the penalty gave them first down again, but it's second and 34. Two receivers each side. Cachagna looks to throw, and that is complete on the far side to Mezzo, and he's out short of the 40. He's going to be out at the 43.
Again, intense pressure. Really coming in. Conquo coming from the left side, leading the charge. Cachagna, you know, you got the feeling he wanted to look deeper, but he just had to get rid of it quickly. Mezzo able to get 8 yards back to make it now third down and 25 to go.
Long way for WPI to get a first down. Coming up on 1 minute to play in the third quarter. WPI needs three scores. Kachagnia has got some room this time, rolling out to his left, has time, throws, intercepted by the Engineers, taken by Schumacher. He's running across the field to the 40, 45, 50, and he runs out of bounds.
Credit that sack, not only to the defensive line that put so much pressure, but that coverage team did not give any room at all. Kachagnia just kind of floated out there in a pile, and Shoemaker makes the grab at about the 27. No receiver really near that ball. If anything, maybe Kachagnia underthrew it because he was on the run. He kind of jumped as he tried to deliver it. He threw it into a pile. His receiver was covered by three RPI guys. Shoemaker, the one in front of those three, is the one who makes the interception. Runs it to the near sideline and all the way down to the WPI 33. And so with that ends WPI's best opportunity of this ballgame to get on the scoreboard.
20-0, RPI leads. Burnett takes a handoff on first down. Can't get away from the man grabbing his ankles. He just could not spin off that, and he stopped after a short gain. That was Carney, Zachary Carney, who had him by the ankle.
Dylan Burnett inching closer and closer to a 100-yard rushing game. Right now he's got 99.
This could be the last play of the third quarter, as RPI is looking at a second and eight, 15 seconds left in the quarter right now. There's less time on the play clock. Peter Kusky gives to Burnett. He's got a nice haul. 25 to the 20, to the 15, 10 to the 5, and he's in for the touchdown. Burnett's in. 3 seconds to go in the quarter, and RPI leads 26-0.
He broke through the initial line of scrimmage there, and by the time he was in the secondary, it was just so wide open. And you can see a huge hole. He skips by a defender at about the 25, and then from there on in, it's like the receivers were so spread out, that made the WPI secondary spread out, and no one was in the middle of the field, which was where Burnett was, running right down the middle, and nobody could close in on him until near about the inside the 5. But Burnett just kept pumping those legs and getting all the way into the end zone.
Merrick on for the extra point. Snap, spot, kick is up. Kick is good. 3 seconds left, third quarter. RPI 27, WPI nothing.
Go as a 31-yard touchdown run for Dylan Burnett. Gives him 130 yards rushing on the night. First score since early in the second quarter. Engineers offense, which got up to such a great start. Touchdowns in each of its first three possessions. Kind of hit this lull point, Kurt, where they were a little bit stagnant, moving the ball, maybe getting a first down or two, then having to punt. There was also an interception on its last possession. But, boy, everything back to clicking on that last drive. Dylan Burnett, 31-yard run, and it's now 27-0 RPI over Worcester Polytechnic. 3 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Merrick tees the ball up for the kickoff. Emmerich and Hannigan back for the return. High short kick, bounced at the 22 and goes out of bounds. Hannigan allowed that one to go out of bounds. So the clock didn't start, so we'll get another play in the third quarter.
Get a chance to throw some numbers out at you again. Dylan Burnett, 16 carries, 130 yards on the night, leading the way for the RPI offense. He's got that one touchdown. Christian Buckley had 8 carries for 46 yards. Last time we saw him, though, he had an injury, was being helped off the field. Quarterback Mac Peter Kusky, 8 of 16 passing, 73 total yards, 2 touchdowns. They haven't had to go up the ball up in the air much at all because their rushing game has just been so devastating tonight. Engineers have run 35 rushing plays for 192 yards. And they've only had to pass the ball 16 times. Quite often over the years, you might see those rushing attempts, passing attempts completely flipped around. when it came to RPI offense. But tonight it's been ground game all night.
WPI after the penalty on the kickoff, starting at the 35-yard line. Trailing by 27 now. Kachagnia is grabbed, and he'll be sacked back at the 27. And that will do it for the third quarter in Troy. It's RPI 27, WPI nothing after three quarters.
Joe Katinas, 31. Linebacker kind of grabbing Kachagnia by the foot and bringing him down for the sack.
So 15 minutes left to go here in Troy in the Transit Trophy game, and RPI with a 27-point lead. WPI has not been in the red zone.
If I'm not mistaken, what, the 37-yard line is the deepest?
27.
27.
They got it at the 27 after,
after the interception. Or a fumble, yes,
yes.
A fumble. And they went backwards. You know, you look at their quarterbacks, and in terms of attempts and completions, it's not that bad. It's 16 out of 24.
How many sacks?
Sounds good, right? 16 completions, 74 yards. So it's not even 5 yards a completion.
But how many sacks are in there?
Right, five. Five sacks tonight, too. You want to take a look at some of the leaders, maybe on defense here. Nate Sicard has three of those five sacks for RPI. Joe Katinas has one. Connor Noyes has one. Total tackles, Noyes has nine. C.J. Lyons, seven. Sicard, five. Deptula has four.
15 minutes are on the big board here at the East Campus Stadium. We are starting the fourth quarter. WPI right to left, RPI left to right across your radio dial. And WPI on the ground to start out this fourth quarter. Chow, John Chow in at running back, gets it to maybe the 32-yard line. But that, you should reset here. It's not going to be third and 13. So the loss for the quarterback sack has put WPI back to make it now a third and long, even though they picked up yards on that second down. Kachagnia out of the shotgun. Emmerich goes in motion, and we get a timeout from the WPI side. They'll call a timeout.
Timeout, WPI. That's their first timeout of the half.
Well, we just had a sort of a critical sequence there in the second half. If WPI was going to get back in the game, it was right at the end of the third quarter there. They had a fumble deep in RPI territory, took over at the 27-yard line, and could get nothing out of it. In fact, had gone backwards. And the final play of that drive was an interception. Kachagnia picked off by C.J. Shoemaker. Right around the 32 of RPI, ran it all the way back to the WPI 33. And two plays after that, Dylan Burnett with a 31-yard touchdown run. So in that sequence of just a handful of plays, you went from WPI, you know, maybe on the edge of getting back into this game, to now it's just 27-0. And
Kachagnia throws on third down, but it's off the hands of Mezzo at around the 50, 45-yard line around there. Would have been a first down with a catch, I think, but it's incomplete, and WPI sends out the punt team. So that's Walker Sutton back deep instead of Lombardi, who is out the rest of the game with an injury. DiLoretto back to punt for WPI. Gets a snap, balls away. Walker Sutton takes that to 30-yard line. Goes to the 35, to the 40, and stays on the seat. 45 breaks a tackle, caught from behind, and forced down after he crosses the 50-yard line. RPI starting out this drive in pretty good field position. 13:59 to go in today's game. RPI 27, WPI nothing.
Number seven, Joe Phillips. And 57, Max Anderson.
So the ball, they'll actually put it right on the 50-yard line. That's where RPI will start.
I think we're going to start seeing some substitutes in here now for RPI.
It looks
on
like
offense, Jake Kazanowski
in
at quarterback, number 19. And I think we have Ming back in at running back now.
So Kazanowski is the quarterback for RPI. Handoff goes to Ming, and Ming's going to get stopped at the, they'll call it at the 46.
So engineers now seemingly having this pretty well locked down at 27-0. Again, that was a, go back on this, that was a crucial set of downs, handful of plays really, in the end of the third quarter. For a moment, WPI had at the RPI 27 a chance to get back in it. A few plays later, they've turned over the ball. Dylan Burnett, 31-yard touchdown run, looking to lock this one up now.
Second down, and Kazanowski's going to keep it himself. We saw this last week when he came in. He is more likely to try to run the ball than Peter Kusky is, and he picks up one to the 45. RPI, if anything right now, wants to run the ball and work the clock down. Getting dark here in Troy. Third down and 5 for RPI at the WPI 45-yard line. Kazanowski out of the shotgun. Looking downfield, looking for a lot, and he's got a man, Palmer, and he's in for the touchdown. Found him around the 10-yard line. He makes it the rest of the way on his own, and RPI leads 33-0.
Well, DJ Palmer lined up on the left side, sort of on the hash mark, and he just sprinted along the hash mark the whole way and just lost his defender. He was 3 yards behind the secondary, and Kazanowski's pass hit him on full stride right at about the 9-yard line, and he just galloped on in, and RPI now running away with this thing, 33-0, 12 and a half minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
45-yard touchdown reception. Snap, spot, kick up for the extra point. That is good. So Merrick puts it home on the PAT. It's 34-0 RPI over WPI with 12:32 to go.
Well, and this has to be feel especially good for the RPI offense tonight. You know, the first two games, they split with Dickinson and Carnegie Mellon. The defense was terrific, but the offense had struggled both days, scored only 21 points, never looked in sync, had a hard time getting any kind of passing game going. But all that's been sort of corrected, at least for tonight. Engineers just rolling it up now on offense, 34-0. You look at the rushing game, 197 yards on the ground for RPI, better than 5 yards a carry. And passing game, they haven't gone to the air all that much, really just 17 attempts, but now 118 yards through the air. So that's 315 yards total offense for RPI, 315 for RPI, and by comparison for Worcester Poly, 76 yards on 43 plays, so less than 2 yards a play.
Merrick to kick off. Low kick, hits an up man, and grabbed and taken at the 25-yard line, and maybe the 27, 28. That was Herzig who got it at the 25. He grabs it, and WPI will be starting out on their side of the field. Where will they put it? They'll put it at the 28. So WPI starting out this drive at the 28-yard line.
RPI defense heads back out on the field. So let's take a look at some of their stats. Connor Noy is leading the way in total tackles. Again, seeming like he's done that more than once. With 9 right now, CJ Lyons with 7, Nate Sicard with 5, Joe Deptula with 4 tackles. Sacks, though, Nate Sicard with 3 for a total of 25 yards lost.
Pass on first down goes incomplete.
RPI caught a little bit of a break there. That should have been pass interference. The RPI defender.
Receivers each side. Chagnia drops back to throw, and he won't. He's going to get sacked back at the 17.
And they're back under 100 yards total offense. And got across, they crossed the century mark for a little while until that sack. That's the, I think, the sixth sack on the night for the RPI defense.
Third and long. I have said that a lot today for WPI. But it's a third and 13 back on their own side of the field. Chagnia rolls out to his right, pass. Frederick has it at the 20, pushes one man, and he's out of bounds short of the 30. He's out of bounds around the 28, sets up a fourth down and three. So he got 10 yards on that play about. Clock continues to run, 4:35 to go in this fourth quarter. 37 to nothing, RPI leaves. As this one is just a matter of time. WPI going for it on fourth down, because why not? Three wideouts, one man in the backfield. Chagnia throws, and that is complete. That'll be a first down on the far sideline. Receiver goes out of bounds at the 35.
Just the seventh first down of the night for Worcester College.
Clock still running, 3:50 to go in today's game. Ball's at the 35 for a first and 10 for WPI. That is the WPI band, by the way. First and 10 for the WPI engineers. On the ground, Chow gets hit after he crosses the line of scrimmage, and they'll have him at the 37, 36 or 37 for a gain of one or two. RPI looking for the first shutout in this Transit Trophy Series since 2006, when they won 26-0 back at 86 Field. Second down and nine. Kachagnia pulls the ball back, and he's going to throw, and he's sacked back at the 25-yard line. Who got him this time? It's Von Tobel?
His seventh sack on the night for the engineers. And
yeah, Von Tobel with the sack. So WPI is back at the 25 for another third and long. This time it's third and 20 with 2:20 to go in today's game.
Kachagnia at quarterback, he's not had a bad night throwing when he gets a chance to throw it, which has not been much. He has completed 11 out of 20. 69 yards, but he's been sacked six times.
Third down and 20. Kachagnia with a three-man rush throws to Emmerich. He's got it near the 30. Picked up 29. Picked up about 4 yards, and that's well short of a first down. So the clock is still running.
Down to 1:45. They're going to go ahead and punt it away.
They're going to punt it away, and if you're RPI, you're just taking knees.
Yeah.
Walker Sutton's signaling a fair catch, and RPI is just taking knees to end the game.
And if it ends this way, RPI will have held their opponents to just 105 yards total offense tonight.
The kick is away. Walker Sutton calls for a fair catch, and he takes that to 32. We have 118 left to go in today's game. RPI 37, WPI nothing.
Just a matter now of running out the clock, making sure nobody gets hurt. Probably just take a knee here. It looks like Kazanowski's going to be out there at quarterback.
So RPI takes a couple of knees, and this one's over with. So engineers, nope, they're not going to take a knee. They're going to run the ball. And Ming's going to take it, and he's going to get tackled at around the 42. I'm a little surprised by this.
Perhaps just trying to get some of your backup players a little bit of action before the game runs out here.
We're under.
But yeah, I'm surprised here.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised. Under a minute to play. RPI can run this. RPI can get this clock down below 40 seconds before they snap the ball, so they wouldn't have to snap it again after this play.
Yeah, this should probably be the last.
Yeah, so
play
this should be
scrimmage.
The last play.
It looks like Hugh's going to get a carry.
And he's going to get a first down. That is Kevin Hughes. He'll get a first down to the WPI 48, and that should be it. We're under 40 seconds to play, and RPI doesn't have to snap the ball again. Except they might. I don't know. The WPI coaches next to us, they have already packed up. And yeah, RPI is not going to snap the ball again. They're going to go to the handshakes now. And there's really no need to snap the ball again. So this one's going to end here. In 5 seconds, it'll be official. RPI 37, WPI nothing in the Transit Trophy game for 2022. And by my count, that's a 2-hour and 21-minute game.
Not a lot of penalties, you know, and
a lot of ground game.
A lot of ground game running out the clock. Hey, look, best game of the season, obviously, for RPI after struggling the first 2 weeks offensively, everything coming on track today, especially on the rushing game, as we mentioned. That was the key here. Dylan Burnett, Christian Buckley, and company just really rolling it up for the RPI offense. You look at the team stats, engineers, 45 rushing attempts. That's got to be the most in a while. I'd have to look it up there. 231 yards on the ground. They did get 151 yards passing, but it was like the passing game was secondary. It was kind of set up by the running game. And, of course, on defense, they were just terrific again all night, keeping Worcester Poly just bottled up, held them to 7 first downs, and just 105 yards total offense. A big part of that reason is they had 8 sacks. 8 sacks. And 5 different guys getting the sacks and pressure all night on the Worcester quarterbacks. Although Worcester completed 20 passes, they only got 119 yards out of it because most of it was by the short pass variety. So a great night for RPI. Shake off sort of the cobwebs from the defeat last week. Offense gets on track. Defense still rocking along seemingly every week. One more non-conference game next week, St. John Fisher, before you move into the conference schedule.
So a 37-0 win for RPI here at East Campus Stadium. I'm going to run down the scoring in today's game. RPI got all they needed, really. 10:28 to go in the first quarter. Kudukoski to Lombardi on a 10-yard pass. Merrick's kick made it 7-0 RPI. Then 3:10 to go in that first quarter. Again, Peter Kuski to Lombardi on a pass, this time 21 yards. The kick was blocked, and it was RPI 13-0 after one quarter. In the second quarter, 10:46 left to go in the first half. On the third RPI possession, these are all consecutive possessions, Walker Sutton with a 2-yard run. Merrick's kick made it 20-0 RPI. That would be the score at halftime. In the third quarter, with 3 seconds to go, Burnett with a 31-yard run. Merrick's kick made it 27-0 RPI. And then in the fourth quarter, with 12:32 to go, Kazignowski hit Palmer for a 45-yard pass. Merrick's kick made it 34-0. And with 6:17 to go, final score of the game, Merrick with a 26-yard field goal made it RPI 37 and WPI nothing. With that, RPI improves to 2-1 on the season. WPI falls to 1-2. If you're curious, I mentioned the last time there was a shutout in the Transit Trophy game. That was back in 2006 at 86 Field. RPI defeated WPI, obviously. It's a Transit Trophy game. It was a 26-0 win. Prior to that, it was 2000 in Troy when RPI won 45-0. And since the trophy's been issued, only RPI has achieved shutouts, and this is the third one after those previous two. Also for RPI, this is the first time they've shut anybody out since Rochester back in 2019 when they shut out Rochester 38-0 also here. And the week before, they had shut out Anna Maria 38-0. So almost a similar score here. A similar score, not exact, but 37-0 RPI with the win over WPI. For WPI, their next game, they are against their home against Montclair State at 3:30 next Saturday. And for RPI, they are on the road at St. John Fisher. That is a noon start next Saturday. Your engineers of the game.
Well, let's start on defense because the engineers are just all over the place. And, gosh, you know, it's hard to even narrow it down to a couple of guys. So many good players had great nights. But tonight, I'm going to go with Nate Sicard. He had 5 tackles. That was good for 3rd on the team, but he also led them with 3 sacks for a total of 25 yards and losses, and all of those were in the first half when RPI was building up what would prove to be an insurmountable lead. So Nate Sicard, your defensive player of the game. But, hey, honorable mention, Connor Noyes had 9 tackles on the game, also 2 sacks. C.J. Lyons had 7 tackles. Spencer Brockdorf broke up a couple of passes and played well in the secondary. Offense, it's a ground game. I mean, everybody contributed and everybody had a role there. And it seemed like any player who got the ball moved it well. But, of course, it's led by Dylan Burnett. He's your offensive player of the game. He had 16 carries, 130 yards total, 1 touchdown. His longest run was a 31-yarder right at the end of the 3rd quarter to put this game away. Dylan Burnett, your offensive player of the game for RPI.
And defense gets a shutout today. They have given up 2 touchdowns this season. Mm-hmm. First week, tipped pass on the second play from scrimmage. Last week, interception return to the 1-yard line, and it was a 1-yard drive by Carnegie Mellon for the only touchdown. So they've given up 1 touchdown on a tipped pass and 1 touchdown when they had to go on the field at the 1-yard line to start the drive.
Right, and also probably equally important to point out, not just tonight, but any night the opponent has seemingly had a pretty good golden opportunity on offense, the RPI defense has responded and just shut them down. Tonight it was 1 sequence in the 3rd quarter, about midway through. RPI's up 20-0, pretty comfortable, but WPI had a fumble returned all the way to the RPI 27, starting out 1st and 10. Hey, midway through the 3rd, if you can get a touchdown here, you're back in the ball game. But the RPI defense really responded like it has all last year and all this year. They pushed them backwards for losses after 2 plays, and then on the 3rd play of that drive, an interception by C.J. Shoemaker. He ran it back from about the RPI 30 all the way down to the WPI 33. 2 plays later, Dylan Burnett rushes in for the touchdown, and there was your game right there. And so that's sort of the point. Even when the opponents have had the ball on the RPI side of the field, had some big opportunity, every week it seems like the RPI defense has just shut it down.
Well, we saw a really great defensive performance last year by RPI. You have most of the starters returning. The majority of the starters are returning to this year. I think that's what we expected from the RPI defense, and that's what we're seeing so far.
And the encouraging sign is the offense is, you know, really performed tonight after a couple of tough weeks. A much better showing tonight. One concern, and we'll obviously see by the next broadcast, the status of Peter Lombardi, a wide receiver who is a little bit of jack of all trades for the Engineers. He had 4 catches and 2 touchdowns. He also is the guy who returns punts. He holds on place kicks. He went out with what appeared to be a knee injury. He was on crutches on the sideline. Certainly don't know his status right now, but he's a key player, and if he's out, that's going to hurt the RPI offense.
So that's going to do it for us here from the East Campus Stadium. Big win for RPI. They maintain possession of the Transit Trophy, improve their record to 2-1. So before we get out of here, we would like to thank the Rensselaer Union. They provide the funding for WRPI and all the club-related activity of the Institute, and that includes WRPI's coverage of Engineer football, hockey, and baseball. Also, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org, and you can pick up our broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. As long as we're sending something out over the air, we'll provide it for you on that feed. Once again, that is WRPI.org. Our next sports broadcast is next Saturday. That is a noon start at St. John Fisher. So RPI goes on the road. Actually, they're going on the road 3 consecutive weekends west on the thruway. St. John Fisher, then a little bit farther to Rochester, then quite a bit farther to Buffalo State. So RPI on the road for the next 3 weeks. Our next broadcast will be next Saturday at noon, RPI at St. John Fisher. Yancey Roy was to my right. My name is Kurt Stutt. We would both like to thank you for listening to today's game. We'd also like to thank back at the station Will and Luna for making sure we got out over the air to you. So thank yous all around. The final score, as we're going to head out of here, from the East Campus Stadium, it was the 2022 Transit Trophy game here in Troy. And the final score, it was RPI 37 and WPI nothing. And you've been listening to live coverage of Engineer Football on 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy.